In Arizona, a dome and air conditioning, those are two good things to have, and we've got both here at State Farm Stadium, just west of downtown Phoenix. So this was the scene a moment ago. The Cardinals emerging from their tunnel, and we are ready for football as the Cards get set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. Now the first carry for Chase Edmonds. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
First carry for James Conner. There to stop him on the defensive side, Fred Warner.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
For this defense, CD, and going up against Kyler Murray here, what's the secret to keeping him in check?
Having better athletes than him, which is really unrealistic. So I go way back in football. They used to have a coverage called the umbrella coverage with 4 defenders back deep. Now you want to try and move that umbrella up front with Kyler Murray, kind of surround him and keep him hemmed into the pocket, because if he breaks out, he's going to hurt your defense in a big way with his legs.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up 2nd and 12. Murray now to throw. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
So 3rd and 2, this quite possibly 4-down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try and run for it with Connor. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And there's James Conner with a run that gets everyone's attention. He joined the Arizona Cardinals after 4 years in Pittsburgh, and his best year with the Steelers, 2018, named a Pro Bowler after a 973-yard, 13-touchdown campaign. Mixed results the last couple of years as he's been in and out of the lineup, but with consistency, he can still be an effective runner.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On 2nd and 11 now, Murray. Well, this is caught by Williams. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss, and now it's 3rd down.
We'll put that one in the win column for the defense. Trying to contain tight ends in the passing game is so difficult nowadays, but they did in a big way there.
3rd and 15 here after the 1st and 2nd down plays went in the wrong direction. Murray gonna throw. Screen pass to Connor. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a 4th down. And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. We're scoreless after 1. Back in Arizona, 2nd quarter action. It's the Cardinals in possession. Prater's kick is good. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. So a pretty good opening drive. That'll make the home fans somewhat happy. They wanted six, but they got three in the early lead.
And they should be happy. The guys look good getting down the field. That's got to give them a little bit of hope that good things are in store here today for them.
Send it away following the made field goal. And Thomas just going to hold on to this one. It's a touchback. And San Francisco gets set to go here. This one a little slow to get cooking. Just a 3-0 scoreline as they begin with a 1st and 10. They'll run with Sermon to begin the drive. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Nice satisfying run on 1st down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Garoppolo looks to throw. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a 1st down.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Sermon now on 1st and 10. And some room to run now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 15 for the Niners there and a 1st down.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's 1st and 10 at the 46. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. And it's 2nd down.
They've given up a few 1st downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And that's dropped underneath to Mitchell. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
Here we go. They'll try and run for the 1st with Sermon. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A gain of 10 and a 49er 1st down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Play fake, Garoppolo. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, 2nd and 10. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Here's Garoppolo to throw. And he's going to be taken down back around the 35-yard line. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This one is right down the middle, and that will tie us at 3-3. So a return of serve, so to speak, here on the second drive of our game as they respond to that opening field goal with three of their own.
I like that. Go a little tennis on me.
I know you. You like to mix it up with sports.
They, yeah. They crack a forehand back at him. They get a backhand. What was the serve? What was the return on?
It was a backhand.
I like that.
Good backhand.
Get some nice top spin on the
a little bit.
I love it. Almost a mirror image when you really get down to it. I thought that was pretty good stuff.
Each team with a possession, each team with a field goal as the kick is away. On the return, Andy Isabella. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. 5 yards on the catch there brings up second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Second and five. Throwing now is Murray. And Murray in trouble here, and down he goes. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot, third and long. Edmonds running out of the shotgun. Edmonds a first down and more. And finally brought down at the 34-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
Second and 10. To throw, it's Murray. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Now Murray. Steps away to his left. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. So possession goes over here on the punt. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
The Niners ready to go on offense for the final time of this first half. And we'll see what they want to do. Just 20 seconds remaining here before the half.
Clock at 20 seconds to go in the half as they come up first and 10. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. So we've reached halftime at a low-scoring affair, just a pair of field goals. 3-3 is our score. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Second half ready to roll. Two field goals, the combined output in half number one. Could be first touchdown wins. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gipper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Throwing is Garoppolo on third down.
They set up the screen for Sermon.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch, I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away.
A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Cards will take over, first and 10. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
Back to the air on second down. It's Murray.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Buying time to his left. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down.
I liked his effort there. He got it done on his own. But let's face it, he puts defenses in a really stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. 39 yards on the punt. Give him just 1 yard on the return. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10.
San Francisco's offense returns to the field.
The last couple of drives have ended in punts. Maybe the crowd minds that, but you're a defensive guy. You're okay with a couple of punt drives.
Listen, I'm the guy that loves a 0-0 pitch game. All right, in baseball, I can handle that going into the seventh inning. I think the crowd, though, they want to see a little bit more excitement. Let's see if someone can break something free on offense and get going.
Offense at a premium the last two drives. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. That's complete, it's Brandon Ayuk. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Garoppolo to Ayuk, first down 49ers.
The 49ers traded up to snag Brandon Ayuk at pick 25 in the 2020 draft out of Arizona State. He was in and out of the lineup a little bit in his rookie year, only played in 12 games, but was awfully productive when he was out there with 60 catches. And there's another one, this time for a first down.
And he'll get this out past the 45 to the 47. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
On second down, it's Sermon, and he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Now a run with Sermon. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30.
62 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw, Garoppolo. That's into the hands of Dwelly. 7 yards, the pick up there.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. 3 yards remain for second down. Throwing now is Garoppolo. They'll find Ayuk open right side. That good for 6 as they keep this drive right on rolling.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. First and 10 at the 19. On the handoff, Sermon. Sharp move, but can't find much space. Dropped just inside the 20. And the all-pro safety, Buda Baker, in on the tackle.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety of being able to hit people with the run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that. MVU. Well done.
And they get Pro Bowl tackle Trent Williams for the infraction there.
And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Garoppolo now. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle, his tight end. But now it's third down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. To throw is Garoppolo. To the right side, it's caught by Mitchell. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception, and that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short game.
And his kick is good. And they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3. We still wait on the first touchdown of the game, but a second field goal now makes it a 6-3 score.
Yeah, I know a lot of people would call this the definition of winning ugly. To me, this is gorgeous. I'm a defender, right? I love these kind of games. The tension is high. Who's going to make the play to win it? And right now, that field goal may be the advantage they need.
The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. On the return, Isabella. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. Arizona's offense back out and ready to go. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ball game. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Here's Murray. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed, too.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. To throw is Murray. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down.
All right, let's just put it on the table real quick here. This is two-minute drill. You got to know they're looking for their number one receiver.
Yeah, you think they'd be ready for that? That time, they weren't. First down now, but that clock rolling. Back to throw, Murray. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
Cardinals got to go quickly, hustling to the line. To throw is Murray. This is caught. It's Kirk. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 18. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. And now all of a sudden, the shoe's kind of on the other foot. Maybe you pull the reins back here a bit?
Yeah, a little bit, because you got to make sure that you don't score too quickly.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Now Murray. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle, so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
Murray to throw. And completes it to Kirk over the middle. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts. as he'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Back to throw. Forced out to his left. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow, wow. How many people are watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Prater for the extra point, and that will make this a four-point game. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. Thomas. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. Garoppolo and the Niners now. Down 10-6, a little over 20 seconds to go. Needing to go pretty much the length of the football field as they have it first and 10. Complete. Down to 15 seconds now.
Probably time for two more shots, and ideally, they'd like to get to midfield or so they have a chance at a Hail Mary on the final play.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Back to throw, Garoppolo. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
That would have been a tough catch, but in this two-minute drill, those are the ones you really hope your guys come up with.
Yeah, you don't want your guy to be able to take the out because it was a tough catch. You needed him to come up with that one, because if he does, it alters the perspective of this two-minute drill, doesn't it?
He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete, so their final drive comes up empty, and with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still... You're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.